Hey guys, this is Abhijit Pal and Ketan Vibhandik. So today we are going to review a very interesting paper which has been authored by Herbert Bay, Tinette Dutelars and Luc Van Goon. It was quite a remarkable paper because it not only provided us with a robust detector and descriptor but also a fast detector and descriptor which can be used for real-time object detection. So let's begin. The task of feature detection and matching is part of many computer vision applications. Automated object tracking, point matching for computing disparity, stereo calibration, motion-based segmentation, object recognition, 3D construction are just a few of many. So what's the motivation behind this paper? The author wanted to have faster interest point detection for real-time application, reduction in the dimensions of the descriptor while keeping it sufficiently distinctive. Also, the detector should be invariant to geometric variations, scale changes, and photometric variations. So before this paper came out in 2006, many research papers were published in this area which laid the groundwork for the authors of the SURF to come up with it. So we will quickly go through with some of the significant ones. The first one is the Harris-Conner detector. The Harris-Conner detector. This gave us a method of detection of interest points using the eigenvalues of the second order moment matrix. However, this method was not scale invariant. The next up is Laplacian of Gaussian. This gave us a concept of automatic scale detection using the Laplacian of Gaussians as well as the Hessian matrix determinant. Next up is Harris-Laplace detector. So this paper worked on the weak points of Harris and gave us a scale invariant feature detector. Here they use Harris-Conner response for interest point localization and Laplacian for scale detection. Next up is SIFT. This paper gave us a faster means of calculating the Laplacian of Gaussian, that is, by approximating it as a difference of Gaussians. Well, SIFT, when it came out, it turned out to be a huge success, but its only problem was its 128 dimensional descriptor, which is quite large. Before we go on to the methodology, there were several comparative studies of the existing method, which helped in the development of SURF. Some of the key results are: Hessian-based detectors are more stable than the Harris-based counterparts. Using the determinants of a Hessian matrix seems to be more advantageous rather than its trace, as it fires less on ill-localized structure. And as discussed earlier, the high dimensionality of SIFT's descriptor is its drawback, and reduction of this dimensionality comes at the cost of accuracy. So let's go through the general overview of SURF. There are two parts, detector and descriptor. Detector. Detector which is based on Hessian matrix and it uses a very basic approximation of DOG, difference of Gaussians. It also uses integral image which was popularized by Wheuler-Jones algorithm and it's going to make the computation really fast. Descriptor. So the descriptor uses hard wavelet responses of the interest point neighborhood and is of only 64 dimensions. And they have also introduced a new indexing step which is based on the sign of the Laplacians. So before we go to the fast Hessian detector, let's briefly discuss about the concept of integral images. As we can see, the input image consists of intensities 1, 5, 2 and 4. So for computing the integral image, we replace every pixel by its sum of pixels above and to the left of the pixel location and also inclusive of the pixel itself. So here you can see 5 has been replaced by 5 plus 1 is equal to 6. And 4 has been replaced by 1 plus 5 plus 2 plus 4 is equal to 12. And so on. So rectangular features can be computed very rapidly by using integral images. Now suppose this is our input image. We want to calculate the sum of the pixel intensities in the rectangular region D. Now when we consider the integral image of the input of this input image, the pixel value at 4 will be A plus B plus C plus D, and the location 2 will be A plus B, and at location 3 it will be A plus C, and at location 1 it will be A. So D is equal to 4 plus 1 minus the sum of 2 and 3. We will see later how this leads to faster computations. So as we said earlier, the SURF detector uses the Hessian matrix determinant, which is used for both scale detection and interest point localization. Here is the general form of the Hessian matrix for two-dimensional. where each of its component is convolution of image and the second order Gaussian derivative. So Gaussians are considered to be ideal for scale space analysis, but in practice, we crop and discretize the continuous Gaussian functions. And also, it has been observed that even with Gaussian filtering, aliasing still occurs during subsampling of the filtered images. So given the non-idealities of the Gaussians and the David Low's successful approximation of LOG, the authors pushed the approximation to another level. They proposed box filter approximation for the Gaussian second order derivatives. The performance of the box filters is quite comparable to the cropped and discretized Gaussians. Now here, the use of integral images is going to give us quite an edge in terms of computational efficiency. Earlier, for finding Gaussian derivative response, we had to convolve the image with the filter whose computational complexity was around O(n) square. But now, due to the use of box filters, we can just compute the sum of pixels intensities in the rectangular area, multiply it with its coefficient, and find a total sum. All this took just O(1) time. Here we have an example. On the left side, we have an approximated box filter, and the right side, the input image. Okay, we can see a rectangular region of constant intensity in the box filter. So, for computing the filter response, we will compute the integral image. Now, after the integral image has been computed, we have to just find the sum of the pixels in the rectangular region. Here, to compute it, we will first identify the boundary pixels, which are 9, 3, and rest are zeros. So the filter response is 9 plus 0 minus 3 plus 0, which is equal to 6. So it took just 4 additions to find the filter response. Now the box filters are denoted by dxx, dyy, and dxy. A second order Gaussian derivative filter of sigma 1.2 is approximated by 9 cross 9 box filter. Sigma equal to 1.2 is the initial scale layer. The weights in the box filter are kept quite simple for computational efficiency, but during the computation of Hessian matrix determinant, we account for it. So it is given as dxx multiplied by dyy minus 0.9 times dxy whole square. Scale spaces are usually implemented as image pyramids. The images are smooth with Gaussians and subsequently subsampled. Due to use of box filters and integral images and the computational efficiency that they provide, we can directly use the upsampled filters, that is filters of greater size, on the original images. So instead of image pyramid, we use filter pyramid. And also, the size of filter is directly proportional to the standard deviation of Gaussian filter. For example, 27 cross 27 corresponds to sigma equals to 3 times 1.2, which is equal to 3.6, and 9 cross 9 filter corresponds to sigma equals to 1.2, which is the initial scale. Now, finally, after getting the responses across the scales, we perform a non-maximum suppression in 3x3x3 neighborhood. So if the pixel is maximum in its own scale's neighborhood and also the scale below it and above it, we classify that point as key point or interest point at that scale.
Now, after detecting the key points in the images, we need to do the matching process to match the corresponding key points. To do that, a key point descriptor is needed. Let's find out how SURF descriptor works. SURF descriptor is a two-step process. The first part is to find the dominant gradient orientation of the detected key point, and the second part computes the descriptor vector of the key point region after aligning it with its dominant gradient orientation. Let's discuss this process in more detail. To compare two detected key points, they must be aligned with each other, but the corresponding detected key point in different images might not have the same orientation. Thus, It is necessary to align the regions to be compared in the same orientation before comparing them. So, to find the orientation, we consider a circular region of radius 6s around the interest point. Remember that the S is the scale of our detected key point. We then take a grid of equispaced points separated by a distance of S between them. This results in approximately 100 points per key point. Now, the gradient in X and Y directions is computed for each of these 100 key points. We use a Haar wavelet filter of dimension 4s to compute the gradients. The Haar wavelet is the simplest possible wavelet. The white region represents plus 1 and the black region represents minus 1. Thus, the output of the filter is simply the summation of pixels in the white region minus the summation of pixels in the black region. Due to its simplicity, this process happens in constant time, as summation of any rectangular region can be found using only 4 operations using an integral image. Notice that due to sampling of the subregions, this process is invariant to the scale of our key point, as we get fixed number of gradients per key point. These gradients are then scaled by a Gaussian of standard deviation 2.5s centered at the key point, so as to give more importance to the points near the center. Now, each gradient pair is represented as a vector centered at the origin. This circle is convolved with a sector of angle 60 degrees. Each summation results in one vector, and the longest among these vectors is chosen as the orientation of our key point. After aligning the path with its dominant gradient direction, its descriptor vector can be computed. For that, we consider a square window of size 20s around the key point. This window is split into 4 x 4 subregions to preserve the spatial information to some extent. Like in the previous step, 5 x 5, that is 25 equispaced points, are sampled in every subregion. This is done to make the features scale invariant. Gradients for these sampled points are scaled by a Gaussian of standard deviation 3.3s centered at the point of interest to increase its robustness towards geometric deformation and localization errors. We extract 4 features for each of the 16 subregions, which are the summation of the gradients in the x direction, the summation of the gradients in the y direction, the summation of the absolute value of the gradients in the x direction, and the summation of the absolute value of the gradients in the y direction. For example, a look at the 3 patches below. The first patch is of a homogeneous region, therefore all 4 values are low. The second patch has stripes in the x direction, thus the summation of the absolute values of gradient in x direction is high, but other feature values remain low. In the last patch, the intensity gradually increases in the x direction, making the first 2 feature values high. This process results in a 64-dimensional feature vector for each key point. Remember that SIFT used a much bigger 128-dimensional feature vector. This SURF feature vector is not only faster to compute but also faster to match, as it requires less number of dimensions. Moreover, to make the features invariant to illumination, these feature vectors are normalized. After obtaining the key point description, these key points are matched by methods like similarity thresholding and one based on the nearest neighbor ratio. In order to speed up the matching process, another feature is added for each key point. It is the sign of the Laplacian, which is nothing but the trace of the Hessian matrix previously computed. Laplacian distinguishes bright blobs on dark background from the reverse situation and requires no extra computational cost. This speeds up the matching process by several times. This is the implementation of SURF algorithm to track an art frame in real time using MATLAB functions. As you can see, the yellow lines are tracking the key points. Now, I'll be changing the scale. Increasing the scale. Decreasing the scale. SURF is also rotation invariant, as you can see. SURF is able to operate at speed high enough to use it in real-time applications.